Good morning, all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And this is my lecture 4 on Unit 5. And the concept is Poynting's Theorem. So today, we are going to learn the Poynting theorems and few examples and solutions. Now, based on the previous studies, that is Faraday's law, displacement current, time varying field, uniform plane wave in free space as well as dielectric. Now, using all those concepts, now we are learning a new theorem called as Poynting theorem. Now, according to Poynting theorem, the development of the theorem begins with one of the Maxwell's curl equation in which the del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. So this is one of the Maxwell's equation. We have derived this in displacement current. So the Maxwell's equation I have considered as del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. Then next step is, let us multiply with the electric field, that is E. So we'll get E dot V cross H, that is E dot del cross H is equal to E dot J plus E dot dou D divided by dou T. So I have taken a dot product of electric field intensity for all the terms in the equation. So now I will define the term, that is del dot E cross H. Suppose I have electric field as well as magnetic field, the cross product of those two as a E cross H. And if I take del dot E cross H, then del dot E cross H is equal to minus E as it is dot del cross H, that is the first term, minus E dot del cross H plus H as it is dot del cross H. So del dot E cross H can be defined as minus E dot del cross H plus H dot del cross E. Now we will use this in this equation, that is E dot del cross H equation. So this equation becomes, that is, I have a term here, that is E dot del cross H. So E dot del cross H can be written as, that is, it this can be written as H dot del cross E minus del dot E cross H. That means this term to the left side and this term to the right side, if you take, then E dot del cross H can be defined as H dot del cross E minus del dot E cross H. So I have substituted in place of E dot del cross H, that is H dot del cross E minus del dot E cross H is equal to, now I have J dot E plus E dot dou D divided by dou T. But we know that dou D by dou T, according to Faraday's law in time varying field, del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So I will write this equation as the left side minus the left side H dot del cross E. So del cross E, I will substitute it as minus dou B divided by dou T, minus dou B by dou T, minus del dot E cross H as it is, plus J dot E plus E dot dou D by dou T as it is. Now I will take this term, that is minus H dou B by dou T to the right side. Then I will get this as minus del dot E cross H is equal to J dot E plus. So here, instead of D, I will write epsilon times E. So I will write this as epsilon times E dot dou E by dou T plus this term is H as it is, and B we will write it as mu into H. Hence, mu into H into dou H divided by dou T. Now, I have a two terms, that is epsilon E dot dou E by dou T and mu H dot dou H by dou T. Now, these two can be written as, that is epsilon E dot dou E by dou T can be written as dou by dou T of half D dot E. So, that is epsilon E is nothing but D. So, I have E dot dou D by dou T can be written as dou by dou T of half D dot E. Similarly, the mu H dot dou H by dou T can be written as dou by dou T of half into B dot H. So, this is in case of electric field and this is in case of magnetic field. Now, I will substitute these two equations in the equation of minus del dot E cross H. That is, minus del dot E cross H is equal to J dot E as it is plus. So, this term can be replaced as dou by dou T of half D dot D. That is, dou by dou T of half D dot E plus dou by dou T of half B dot H. That is, this term can be replaced as, this term can be replaced as dou by dou T half B dot H. Now, the next step is, I'll integrate volume integration in all the terms. Then I'll add the volume integration of del dot E cross H dV is equal to volume integration of J dot E dV plus integration of dou by dou T of half D dot E dV plus integration of dou by dou T of half B dot H dV. That is, I have taken the integration, volume integration across all the terms. Then the first term, the volume can be replaced with the surface as, this can be written as minus, for a closed path, the surface integration of E cross H, that is del will get cancelled with one of the integral, then we will get it as integration of minus as it is E cross H ds is equal to J dot E dv plus dou by dou T of half D dot E dv plus dou by dou T of half B dot H dv. That is the volume integration, and this can be written as, that is the left hand side, that is the surface integration of our closed path E cross H. So the term E cross H, it is in, it can be written as the pointing vector S. So the pointing vector is nothing but, it has a surface integration with the volume integration. That too, in volume integration, there is a current density term, the electric field term, as well as the magnetic fields term. So, this equation, we will call it as pointing equation, and theorem is pointing theorem. So, the term E cross H is called as pointing vector and is denoted by S. That is, S is equal to E cross H. So, one is volt per meter, another one is ampere per meter. So, because S is given by the cross product, that is E and H. So, this is E and H. So, this is nothing but, since it is one is volt per meter and ampere per meter, this is nothing but, in terms of power, we can define now. In terms of power. So, that is nothing but watt per meter square. That is V bar M. A bar M is nothing but W bar M square, watt per meter square we will write. That is a pointing vector. Yes. So it is given by cross product of E and H, and the direction of the power flow at any point is normal to both E and H vectors. And this is certainly agrees with the concept what we have done in uniform plane wave is the propagation is in that direction and the wave is associated with an EX as well as AY component. So that means we can write it as EX AX plus HY AY is equal to S into AZ. That means it is propagating in Y direction and it has X and Y component. So we can write this as EX is equal to EX naught cos omega t minus beta z. And HY we will write it as EX naught divided by eta into cos omega t minus beta z, where eta is the intrinsic impedance. And from this we can define the power density amplitude is given by S is equal to E naught X square, that is EX naught square divided by eta. So this is E X naught square divided by eta into this term. So E cross H is nothing but the power density, what we have defined, the pointing vector S, that is watt per meter square. So this is what we will call it as a pointing theorem and the pointing vector and the power density concept. Now we will do some simple examples to learn the pointing vector in detail. That is, first example, in free space, the electric field is equal to 50 cos omega t minus beta z AX component volt per meter. Now find the average power crossing a circular area of radius 2.5 meter in the plane z is equal to 0. Assume em is equal to hm into e naught and hm into intrinsic impedance, and the impedance is given by eta is equal to 125 omega, that is 377 ohms, both are same. So in free space they have given E, and they are asking us to calculate the average power. So average power, if I want to calculate, now from E, now first I will write H, that is H is equal to 50 divided by eta naught, because H is E by intrinsic impedance. So E as it is divided by intrinsic impedance, and we will define it in Y component. Then H is equal to 50 divided by eta naught is 125. They have given in the numerical and this term as it is. So this is H. Now we will find out H conjugate, the conjugate of H, this term. So conjugate of this term is, we will get here, instead of J, this becomes minus J. So the minus sign, if we take inside, then H conjugate will become 50 divided by 125 into e to the power j into minus omega t plus beta z in AY direction. So from pointing theorem, we can find out the average power. That is, actually they are asking us to calculate average power, but we have defined the term power as E cross H. But if I want the total average power, then average power, P average is equal to half into real part of E cross H. That is half into E value. E value is 50. The real part of E value is 50. And H value is 50 divided by eta naught. That is 50 divided by 125. So this is E and this is H. So I need only the real part. So I multiply only this term and divide, that is 1 by 2 into 50 into 50 divided by 125. If I calculate this value, so this value will become P average. Average power is equal to 3.31572 in AZ direction watt per meter square. So this is the average power. Now I need average power which is crossing the circular area of radius 2.5. So there is a total area I need to calculate, the circular area. So A is equal to pi r square. So pi into r square. The circular area of the radius is 2.5 meter. So radius is 2.5. Hence we will substitute r is equal to 2.5 whole square. Then area I will get it as 19.6349 meter square. So this is the area. Now what is the total average power crossing circular area? Then average power is equal to the calculated power into area at which it is crossing. So the calculated power is 3.31572 and the area is 19.6349. Substitute these two and find out the average power crossing the circular area, and we will get it as 65.1 watt. The power crossing circular area, we will get it as 65.1 watt. Hence, the Poynting theorem is used to calculate the average power as well as the average power crossing the areas. So this is the best application of Poynting theorem. That is, Poynting theorem is used to calculate the average power which has both the component of E as well as H. Let us take the second example. That is, for a wave traveling in air, the electric field is given by E is equal to 6 cos omega t minus beta z in AZ direction at F is equal to 10 megahertz. Calculate the average Poynting vector. Simple problem. They have given E, electric field intensity, at a frequency F. And now the question is to find out the average Poynting vector. So E is equal to 6 cos omega t minus beta z in AX. Then H will become E by eta. So what is the value of intrinsic impedance here? It is 377 because wave is traveling in air, free space. So we will get it as 6 divided by 377. And the H value we got. Now average power is half into real part of E cross H conjugate. That is, E value is 6AX into AZ and H component is 6 divided by 377. So that is half AZ and AY. So the final answer is P average, we will get it as 0.0477 in AZ component. Very much similar to your previous concept. Since you will get AZ component, here also we will get it as AZ component. Answer is 0.0477. Next question, important question for the point of exam, that is, a radio station transmits power radially around the spherical region and the desired electric field intensity at a distance of 10 kilometer from the station is 1 millivolt per meter. Calculate the corresponding HP and the station power. Now we need to calculate the station power. So electric field intensity E is equal to 1 millivolt per meter and the radio station is transmitting a power radially around the spherical region and the distance is R is equal to 10 kilometer. Now, what is the magnitude of magnetic field now? That is H is equal to E divided by eta naught. So eta naught value is 120 pi. So we will get it as E value is 1 millivolt per meter, 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by eta. We will get it as H is equal to 2.65 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere per meter. We will get H is equal to 2.65 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere per meter. Now I need to calculate the corresponding value of H. H we have done. Now power and the station power. Now let us calculate the power. Now the magnitude of the power is nothing but P is equal to E into H. So E value is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. Because 1 millivolt per meter and H value is 2.65 into 10 to the power minus 6, and I will substitute both E value as well as H value to find the value of power. Then power I will get it as 2.65 into 10 to the power minus 9 watt per meter square. Now since it is in spherical region, now let us calculate 4 pi r square value with the r value as 10 to the power 4 distance. That is r value is 10k, hence 10 to the power 4. And 4 pi r square value, we will get it as 12.5663 into 10 to the power 9 meter square. That is, this is the area of the spherical region. That is 12.5663 into 10 to the power 9 meter square. We will get it as area of the spherical region. Now, I need what is the total power radiated over the spherical region means? I need to calculate power with respect to the area what we have calculated. Then the power is equal to power density into area, and power density we have calculated as 2.65 into 10 to the power minus 9 into area is 12.5663. I have substituted and I will get this as 3.33 watt. I'll get this value as 3.33 approximately. Now with this, let us move to the next question, next example. Eight watts per meter square is the pointing vector of a plane wave traveling in free space. Now calculate the average energy density. That is, the formula P is equal to half E naught square by eta naught. That is E cross H only, but H we will write it as E by eta naught. So I will write this as E naught square by eta naught. And since it is in a free space, eta naught value is 377. Then the pointing vector is given as 8 watt per meter square. And so let us substitute the value of density, power density 8 is equal to half into E naught square divided by eta naught. Eta naught value should be 377 because it is in free space. Then eta naught square is equal to, we will get 16 into 377 E naught square. So from this I will get E naught is equal to 77.666 volt per meter. 77.666 volt per meter is the answer. Now let us take the next example. For a wave traveling in air, the electric field is given by E is equal to 6 cos omega t minus beta z. At a frequency of 10 megahertz, then calculate beta, h and average pointing vector. So the medium is air, the wave is traveling in air and the electric field is given. So from this I need to calculate beta, phase constant, then h, magnetic field intensity, and average pointing vector. Now, for air as a medium, the velocity of propagation is, it travels with the velocity of light, that is v is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second we will get. Then from this, let us calculate a wavelength. Lambda is equal to C divided by F, and C value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by the frequency they have given as 10 megahertz. That means 10 into 10 to the power 6 is equal to 30 meter is the wavelength. Now if you have a wavelength, then you can easily calculate the value of phase constant beta as 2 pi divided by wavelength. So 2 pi divided by 13, we will get the value as 0.2094 radian per meter. The phase constant beta value, we will get it as 0.2094 radian per meter. Let us calculate EH. So to calculate EH, we have a formula, H is equal to E divided by eta naught. But eta naught value, that is intrinsic impedance for free space, is 120 pi, or else it is 377 ohms. Then H is equal to E divided by eta naught, and E value they have given as cos omega t minus beta z in AY direction. In AX direction they have given, and we will get it as H is equal to 6 divided by 377 cos omega t minus beta z in AY direction, ampere per meter. That is second one is done. The third one, let us calculate average pointing vector, that is P average is equal to half into real part of E cross H. So P average is equal to, I need to calculate P average. So let us write E. E is 6 e to the power j omega t minus beta z in AX direction. That is in phasor form I have written. Similarly, H is 6 divided by 377. And H conjugate is 6 by 377. Minus j of omega t minus beta z in AY direction, that is H conjugate. Hence, the average pointing vector is given by half into E cross H conjugate, that is H conjugate. So it is 6 e to the power j omega t minus beta z in AX direction cross 6 divided by 377 into e to the power minus j omega t minus beta z in AY component. Then P average we will get it as. P average we will get it as 0.0477 in AZ direction watt per meter square. We will get average pointing vector as 0.0477 in AZ direction watt per meter square. With this, let us do the next example. That is, a plane traveling wave has a peak electric field E naught of 15 volt per meter. And if the medium is lossless with a mu r equal to 1 and epsilon r equal to 12, find first one, velocity of the wave, second one, impedance of the medium, and third one is peak pointing vector. So first I need to calculate the velocity of the wave. So from the equation, from the given data, epsilon r equal to 12 and mu r is equal to 1. Hence, velocity of the wave is given by v is equal to 1 divided by under root of mu into epsilon, and mu value is mu naught into mu r, and epsilon value is epsilon naught into epsilon r. So let us substitute v is equal to 1 divided by under root of mu naught value 4.2 10 to the power minus 7 into mu r is 1 they have given, and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 into epsilon r value they have given as 12. So hence calculate the velocity of the wave and we will get it as 86.5435 10 to the power 8 meter per second is the velocity of the wave. That is 86.5435 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second we will get as velocity of the wave. Similarly, calculate the impedance. That is, eta is equal to under root of mu naught mu r by epsilon naught epsilon r. And we know that under root of mu naught by epsilon itself is our impedance, eta naught in free space, that is 377, into under root of mu r by epsilon r. Mu r is 1, epsilon r is 12. Hence, we can calculate the intrinsic impedance of the lossless media and we will get it as 108.83 ohms. We will get the value as impedance equal to 108.83 ohms. Now the last one, that is to calculate a pointing vector P is equal to, it is E into H, E naught into H naught, or else E naught into H naught can be written as E naught divided by eta. Hence P is equal to E naught square by eta. Eta we have calculated 108.83 and E naught value is 15 volt per meter. That is 15 square divided by 108.83 and we will get the value of pointing vector as 2.067 watt per meter square. The pointing vector we will get it as 2.067 watt per meter square. Let us do the next example. That is, a plane wave propagating in free space has a peak electric field of 750 millivolt per meter. Find the average power through a square area of 12 centimeter on a side perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So that means we need to calculate the average power through a square area of 12 centimeter of a side. So let us calculate first the average power, that is P average is equal to half EM HM, that is half EM, and HM value we will write it as EM divided by eta naught. So we will get average power is equal to half into EM square divided by eta naught, that is intrinsic impedance. Hence average power is equal to half into EM square, that is 750 into 10 to the power minus 3, because 750 millivolt per meter it is, 750 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square divided by eta naught for a free space, the value is 377 volts. So from this we can calculate the average power as 0.74602 milliwatt per meter square is the average power. So average power we have calculated as 0.74602 milliwatt per meter square. But we need to calculate the average power through a square area of 12 centimeter side. So if I want to calculate the total area of a square is 12 centimeter, that is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 12 into 10 to the power minus 2, because 12 centimeter is the side of a square. So I'll get total area as 0.0144 meter square is the total area. Then the average power through a square perpendicular to the direction of propagation of a plane is power is equal to average power into area. So average power we have calculated as 0.74602 into area is 0.0144. Then we will get the total power as 10.742 microwatt is the total power. So this is how we will do the numericals on Poynting vector, that is Poynting theorem. We will use the Poynting theorem to calculate the average power, the average power crossing through a particular area. And based on these discussions, let us answer some simple quiz questions. That is, the product of E and H gives a new quantity which is expressed as watt per unit area, and it is called as option A power, option B power density, or option C energy density. The answer is option B power density. We have already calculated the power density watt per unit area. Option is B power density. Let us see second one. The total power passing through a particular area is given by power is equal to, is it power density into area, power density by area, or power density plus area? So we have done numerical on this also. That is, the power passing through particular area is power is equal to power density into area. That is option A is the correct answer. Power density into area. So these are the answers to the quiz question what we have done. So today we have seen the Poynting theorem, the derivation, and some examples along with the solutions related to Poynting theorem. Thank you all. Thank you very much.